Hello everyone, welcome to Hope and Wellness channel. I'm Omid, your host, and today we're going to talk about diabetes. And we want to see what it is, we want to see its symptoms, how we can diagnose it, and we want to see if it is manageable and curable. So they're saying that it's not curable, it's a genetic problem, you get it once and it just gets worse and worse and worse, and there is no escape from it. We want to see if that's 100% accurate and is it actually true or not. So let's get to it. Okay, let's talk about its origin and let's start with the meaning of the name. So diabetes comes from a longer name, diabetes mellitus, which is a Latin word. And it means passing through sugar. So in the ancient world, like thousands of years ago, they knew that the human can have a condition that it requires drinking a lot of water and they would go out and urinate a lot more than normal. So that was the first symptoms that they would see. And it comes with like craving sugar and not getting satiated by the food and wanting to eat more and more. So they knew this condition, and the way to diagnose it was to look at the urine and see if by urinating somewhere, if there is any ant gathering around it. So ants would want to, you know, to eat sugar, and they would go around the urine to get that, you know, sugary taste of it. The other way of diagnosing it was by actually tasting the urine. So physicians would taste the urine of the patient and see that if it's sweet or not. So the condition was defined by passing through sugar through the body. So a lot of sugar is in the body and the body cannot handle it and let it go. So that was the condition. So it's a known condition to humankind. But in the modern medicine and during the recent years, we have ways to diagnose and measure different things in the body. So we have ways other than tasting urine of the patient to know that. So what do? We actually measure the blood sugar. What is the blood sugar? Blood sugar is glucose. And the glucose, as we have defined it before in the previous videos, please go and watch them if you haven't so far. Blood glucose is a monosaccharide, is the simplest form of the sugar molecule. And it's the molecule that every cell in the body knows how to use and how to metabolize to produce energy and to live. Okay, so that's the time. How much of it we need? Between 4 to 5 grams at each time. So at each moment, the whole body needs around 4 to 5 grams of sugar, and that's enough. So anything higher than that means that your blood sugar is high. And as we have spoken about it in previous videos, blood sugar is corrosive to the body. It's damaging body cells. If it's higher than normal, your body is getting damaged by that extra amount. So that extra amount, until you manage the blood sugar and lower it down again to the normal level, that time that the blood sugar is high, that extra amount is attaching to different cells in the body and damaging them and disrupting their mechanism and doing many bad things. So that's one of the bad things that it does. And then the way that the body manages that, it just adds to the damage. So we're going to talk about that as well. So nowadays, in modern medicine, we have other ways of diagnosing this condition. So we measure the blood glucose directly. So you go and get a fasted blood test and they draw the blood, they measure the amount of blood glucose in that sample, and they tell you that you have like your blood glucose is 100 or 110 or 80 or 90. And if it's above 110, that would tell you that you have diabetes. If it is between 100 and 110, they would say that you have prediabetes and things like that. So you need to go on a medication, or you need to be careful with what you're doing in your life. Okay. There is another way of looking at this condition, which is a bit more advanced and gives you a bigger picture of your health. And that's called HbA1c, hemoglobin A1c. And that's actually measuring the damage that the sugar is doing to the body. Okay. So naturally, as we have defined it before, if you put sugar and protein together and let them go, they attach and they bound together and they glycate. Okay. So that's called glycation. So they would measure this glycation in the hemoglobin part of the red blood cell. They tell you a number. Okay, and if it's high, it means that you have higher of this glycation, and it means that you have higher blood sugar. So HbA1c tells you how much blood sugar you had during the past 2 to 3 months. Okay, so they say 2 to 3 months, but it can vary from 2 to 4 or even higher or lower, depending on different factors. So why I'm telling you this because all of these tests, the combination of all of this together could give you a picture of your health, but not any of them on its own is enough to conclude that you have the condition or not. So for example, this HbA1c, so let me first define what it is. The hemoglobin. So hemoglobin is the protein part in the red blood cell that is carrying the oxygen. So your red blood cell is responsible to carrying oxygen from your lungs to different parts of the body. So you can oxidize the food, you can metabolize the food and produce energy. And in the process, like the output of that process is carbon dioxide that you breathe out. Okay, so you inhale oxygen, you exhale carbon dioxide. That input of oxygen gets carried around the body by this hemoglobin. Okay, that's that protein. So when your blood sugar is higher, the level of the glycation of this protein in the red blood cell is higher. So the lifetime of red blood cell is between 2 to 3 months. Okay, so they say 3 months, it could vary. So we expect that by that 3 months, when we see the red blood cell and we measure the glycation on that, we think that during the past 3 months that these red blood cells have been living, they had chance to get glycated. And if the glycation rate is higher, that means that you've had higher blood sugar during that 2 to 3 months. Okay. But it's not accurate. 100% accurate. So it's on its own, it doesn't give you the full picture, because your red blood cell can live 2 months, or you can be very healthy and you can produce and generate red blood cells that are very healthy and they're strong, and they can live up to 4 months or even longer. So that means that you might have higher HbA1c, but it's not because you had higher blood sugar. Okay, so if you want to have the full picture, you need to have the fasting blood glucose first, and then have the HbA1c as well. And then together, that can give you a picture of that. And we're going to see a bit of, you know, details of how we can, how the body manages the blood sugar, and you'll have more understanding of this. The other thing that they do is a glucose tolerance test. And that's like, they ask you to come in fasted. They give you a glucose solution, like a glass of glucose, and they would measure your blood glucose on different intervals. So yeah, they would measure that beginning, and then you drink that glucose solution, 100% glucose. And they would see that, like, after 1 hour, after 2 hours, after half an hour, how much your blood glucose is going try and how your body is handling that. So if your body is handling that very well, it means that you don't have diabetes. So your body is able to manage the blood sugar. That's a very accurate test, okay? So it's actually seeing how much your body is able to manage the blood sugar by giving the body high amount of blood sugar instantly and then monitoring what it does. But it's not very common, so I haven't done it myself. And I haven't seen actually anyone close to me to have done that, but it's very common. It's not overly common. Okay, so those are the traditional ways of diagnosing this condition. What do I mean by traditional? I mean that these ways of measuring, they have been known to physicians and the medical community for many years. We all have had fasting blood glucose test, and we know that what does it mean to have high blood sugar or low blood sugar and stuff like that. Thank you.